She's waiting for those opportunities. Look at that, jumping guard. Realizing the clinch, the takedown's not quite working. Let me see what I can do here. The panda holding like a koala bear here as he grabs onto the octopus and works her way to the side. It'll be interesting to see what the coaches tell her to do, where to go. They don't want to take her down, right? But she's going to put her up against the wall, maybe try to wear out the arms of Michelle Nicolini, but she's been grappling for decades. It's going to be hard to wear out those arms in those types of positions.
What would you do, Dragon? What would you do here if you were Zhong Jinnat?
I think they want to try to shake her off. I don't think they want to put her on the ground because then you're going to go into her guard and give her that opportunity. But if she shakes, see how she's shaking up and down? The guard might loosen, and she might have to readjust and put her feet down on the ground.
You both know the rules. Fight fair, fight clean.
Nicolini, if it goes to ground, it will be all her. She tries to pick that ankle early on. Zhong Jinnan stays vertical. Nicolini holding on though to this ankle, Mitch.
Yeah, Michael, that octopus is a very good sort of metaphor of exactly what's going on. The way that she is transitioning to these ankles is incredible. Now she's working her way back up into the body lock. You can see the speed advantage that Zhong Jinnan has in this matchup. And it was a great sort of tactic to slow her down to get into this clinch. And she pulls guard, elevates with the butterfly hooks. Now she's got those legs on the inside of the hips of Zhong Jinnan. Zhong Jinnan's going to try to kind of sort of cover the arms to make sure she can't start grabbing the head and utilize leverage to apply this. She's trying to elevate, and she's looking possibly to create a sweep where she can reverse this position and put Zhong Jinnan on her back so that she can take control. There's the elevation. Good job by Zhong Jinnan to escape that position. Anytime this match hits the ground, it's extremely dangerous. I kind of compared Michelle Nicolini to being that of like a bear trap, that out of nowhere she can just clamp onto you, and then that's the end of your night. You can't go anywhere. And it happened lightning fast. So this is where Zhong Jinnan needs to keep it.
Nicolini looking for a way to lock on and take her down. Now on the back, Nicolini throws the leg up momentarily. Don't forget, folks, Revolution is coming September 24th. Three world title main events on the one night. Revolution, September 24th.
See, Michael, that's what I was talking about with giving Michelle Nicolini an extra limb, because when Zhong Jinnan is throwing those kicks, it creates an opening for Michelle Nicolini to grab the leg and enter into a possible takedown. She needs to keep her hands going and keep those feet kind of to herself, use those for movement, but light her up and try to hurt her on the feet with the hands.
Referee Olivia Koss stands up Michelle Nicolini. This is back at range for Zhong Jinnan. Member formerly of the Chinese national boxing team, Zhong Jinnan. And at the moment, China's last remaining mixed martial arts world champion. Jab two to a round kick. Good combination from the champ. Resets now. It's all about the ground for Nicolini. She could not match the striking with Zhong Jinnan. She knows it. We know it.
Woo!
And it goes to ground. Oh, smack bang! The big right hand from Zhong Jinnan drops Nicolini. There's the power of the punching panda. But is she going to go to ground with Nicolini? She does. Hammer fist strike.
Oh,
Mitch,
man.
How about this?
That right hand, Michael, that was a thing of beauty. It was timed in perfectly. And now, Zhong's, yeah, that's it. Let her up. You can't go to the ground with her. Michelle still doesn't look like the cobwebs are gone. She's still rattled. This is Zhong Jinnan's opportunity to capitalize. You can see the way Michelle is reaching for the legs. That's going to open up her head a lot. It was a great setup by Zhong Jinnan to throw the kicks to open up the punches to the head. I was wrong. That was beautiful, Michael. Look at that. Caught her again with it.
Shrugs her off to Zhong Jinnan, slings the legs now the champion, and says, get up, Michelle. Nicolini has tasted the power of the punching panda, and she didn't like it.
But Michelle's going to get a break here in about 30 seconds. She's going to survive this round. Maybe she can get her bearings back. But Michelle has proven through history that she is most dangerous in these first five. And if you can get past those first five, now that leads, you know, to possible success. Oh, nice takedown there. The way she kept that leg. It's a double-edged sword with those kicks coming from Zhongjing Nam. This is exactly where Michelle wants to be with the kickstand right there, a la Hoy Henzo Gracie with the kickstand trying to drag her down. Beautiful takedown defense. Saw it coming. Easily stepped away from that. Michelle's got to set that up. She's got to come in with the punches, get Zhongjing Nan to raise her hands, and then shoot in for the takedown. Right up against the wall is a good time to do so, too. Zhongjing Nan does her best work when she's going forward. Nice leg kick there. Looks like Michelle just fell down. Michelle Nicolini's looking gassed right now, Michael. You can see now the Zhongjing Nan starting to feel herself, starting to push forward, nice and light on her feet. Think about Zhongjing Nan, she's got a massive gas tank. She does not get tired. I've never seen her get tired, and she's done a shark tank and just going through person after person. Those are high-level black belts, so she is used to being on the ground with very highly skilled Brazilian jiu-jitsu practitioners at Evolve. And right now, she's having her way with Michelle.
Zhongjing Nan, can she find the right? Beautiful jab, slipped it through the defenses of Nicolini. Overhand right from Zhongjing Nan. Nicolini, a little frustrated here, Dragon.
Yeah, you can see that it's a speed advantage that Zhongjing Nan has. She came in with that jab, snapped the head back. It's demoralizing when your opponent is just kind of lighting you up like that and there's nothing you can do. I like this strategy of the forward pressure coming from Michelle Nicolini, but she's got to keep going forward. She can't allow Zhongjing Nan to control that pace and that pressure. There's that overhand right again. Stung Michelle, snapping the head back. I like the feints coming from Zhongjing Nan. She needs to keep those coming. Get Michelle thinking about things. And now might be a good time to start attacking the legs. She does just that, but again, Michelle catches the leg kick and shoots and able to challenge her up. Look at this. Has the Ashigarami right now. Let's see if Zhongjing Nan can defend this Ashi. Oh, she used the other leg to sweep it out. There's a heel hook she might be looking for. That's an Achilles lock. Pressure on the Achilles tendon. Not quite a heel hook yet. The Achilles lock is just painful. It just creates a lot of pressure on the lower calf. It's a painful maneuver, but it doesn't create the torque of like a heel hook that's gonna.
Well, Michelle Nicolini, could she find a finish on Zhongjing Nan here in the second round? But Zhongjing Nan has shown tremendous resilience in the past. We know how hard it is to step out Zhongjing Nan as she's out of trouble, Dragon.
Good job by Jing Nan to stand up and avoid the ground. You still, even if Michelle Nicolini is showing signs of fatigue, you don't want to tangle with her on the ground. You have to stop those positions, find a little bit of space, and then get back up to your feet. Good movement coming from Zhongjing Nan. I see, I like how she comes in and out. Michelle is just kind of frozen right there. You can see the way she's reaching. I'd like to see Zhongjing Nan kind of set those up a little bit, because when she's reaching for the head, or she's reaching for the foot rather, it opens up the head, and that's when Zhongjing Nan could probably get that knockout that she said she wanted so badly. Olivier Cost is forcing that action. Let's see how fast and light on her feet Zhongjing Nan is, but she's still tentative. She realizes that she's still got 15 minutes to work here, so she needs to pace herself. And just because Michelle Nicolini seems like a sitting duck, she doesn't want to overexpose herself and risk getting taken down and finished.
You've got to wonder if Michelle Nicolini's gas tank is depleted here, breathing with her mouth open at the moment, Nicolini, which is never a good sign in the final seconds of this round. Backing her up, left hand. The punches of the champion are troubling Michelle Nicolini. The mouth open on the challenger. And Mitch Chongjinnan is one of those athletes who seemingly always comes forward and never gets hurt. And that is to mentally deflate an opponent like Michelle Nicolini.
See, there's the kick. It gave Michelle the opportunity to charge in, get Chongjinnan a little bit off balance, and she was able to get inside the clinch. That's what she's waiting for. She's waiting for those opportunities. Look at that, jumping guard. Realizing the clinch, the takedown's not quite working. Let me see what I can do here. The panda holding like a koala bear here as he grabs onto the octopus and works her way to the side. It'll be interesting to see what the coaches tell her to do, where to go. They don't want to take her down, right? But she's going to put her up against the wall, maybe try to wear out the arms of Michelle Nicolini, but she's been grappling for decades. It's going to be hard to wear out those arms in those types of positions.
What would you do, Dragon? What would you do here if you were Chongjinnan?
I think they want to try to shake her off. I don't think they want to put her on the ground because then you're going to go into her guard and give her that opportunity. But if she shakes, see how she's shaking up and down? The guard might loosen, and she might have to readjust and put her feet down on the ground. I wouldn't mind seeing her push the leg down.
And as Dragon, I was going to say, with the referee come close there, they're almost stopping that one, but it doesn't matter now because we're straight back into the action, and I guess that Chongjinnan has the result she was looking for with that shake, as you mentioned.
Yeah, I think that, though, the referees, it's hard, be hard to stop that because that's such a pivotal position because of the strategy that's kind of playing out here. You can see good control from Chongjinnan to see how she's pinned down the left arm of Michelle Nicolini with her leg. That's smart. This is a very dangerous position for Chongjinnan to be in. She's going to try to push down the left leg of Michelle Nicolini and maybe try to work past that guard. But passing the guard of a BJJ world champion would be a victory all unto itself.
Let alone an eight-time BJJ world champion and a BJJ Hall of Famer in Michelle Nicolini. Never has such a decorated grappler won a mixed martial arts world title. But that's what Michelle Nicolini is trying to do tonight. To do it, she's got to defeat the most dominant strawweight champion of all time in Chongjinnan.
Good job to create a little bit of separation from Chongjinnan to drop a little bit of the ground and pound. I'd like to see her being a little bit more active with the punching with the right side, but if she starts to punch with the right, she gives the opportunity for Michelle Nicolini to create that space and look for a triangle. You see how high her left leg is on the shoulder? She's going to try to take Zhongjinnan's right hand and shove it between her legs so she can throw up that triangle and look for a submission. Now it looks like she's going for a go-go plata, trying to take her left leg and place her shin underneath the chin of Chongjinnan, but I think she might run out of time because she's pretty close. Might go to an arm bar, looks like, yeah. Ran out of time. See, that's how dangerous she is, Michael. Hard for Michelle Nicolini to stop. The body kick, she's able to catch, push forward, and rush kind of her way into a takedown. The outside leg kick, she's able to reach down and snatch that up with her left hand and get a takedown that way. But the inside leg kick, that one's a little bit harder to reach for Michelle Nicolini. I'd like to see Chongjinnan keep going to that inside leg kick. Attacking the calf with the outside. Those leg kicks are going to be hard because it's going to be hard for Michelle Nicolini to be explosive and move forward. There's that overhand right.
Nicolini needs to find a way to swing the momentum in her favor. But she said earlier in the week, I know I can't go toe-to-toe in the striking with Chongjinnan. I just can't. It's not in my wheelhouse. She's got to find a way to get Chongjinnan down. And those low singles she's attempting to pick the ankle of the world champion just aren't working for her. So, Mitch, what are the options here for Michelle Nicolini?
I like the way she kind of rushes into the takedown. I don't really like it technically, but it is effective. You know, if she's aggressive in her takedown, she isn't doing this, right? She's going forward. She has Chongjinnan on her back foot. She just needs a little bit of an opening. So she's got to find a way to create that opening. And right now she's doing it off of kicks. But I'd like to see her punch her way into a possible takedown. You can see how she's moving forward now. Let's see if she can kind of change the strategy here. There it is. Immediately explodes into it, but Zhong Jinna does the right thing, circles away, and is able to avoid that possible clinch or takedown.
Mitch, do you see Zhong Jinna playing this same game for the next round and a half, or do you see her trying to finish Michelle Nicolini, or does she know that she's ahead? Does she know she just needs to consistently do this pace and keep Michelle at bay, and she'll outpoint her?
Well, I think with the feints and sort of the kicks, she's kind of got a game plan sort of strategized, right? To the left hook, she was able to touch her on the chin. If she continues to do this, continue to use these feints and sort of set things up, she's going to see bigger and bigger openings, especially as Michelle Nicolini starts to get tired and fatigued. Because that overhand right that connected early in the match was a huge door open, and there's an uppercut, right? That was nice. Good defense.
Is there a sense of pressure, though, Dragon, on Zhong Jinna that she should be able to finish someone like Nicolini who doesn't have striking to compare with her?
I think pressure is there every single time she competes. I know Jinna, I know she puts a lot of pressure on herself to not only perform well, but to represent her country. You know, being the first and really only Chinese mixed martial arts champion means the world to her, and she carries that into every single match. And now, I know she wants the finish, but more than that, I think she just wants to keep her belt, you know? Being the first and only strawweight world champion, it meant a lot to her, and I think that any victory is going to be good.
Folks, these are the facts. It is all up to Michelle Nicolini to do. If she wants to wrest the world title from around the waist of Zhong Jinna, time is now the enemy of Michelle Nicolini. She's got to find a way to get Zhong Jinna on the canvas to keep her there and submit her. Because if it stays on its feet, Zhong Jinna is going to continue just to dominate her.
See, but these are her opportunities, Michael. See how her back's up against the wall? If Michelle commits and goes forward, she's trying, but she's throwing that right hand. I'd like to see maybe cut off the corner, throw a hook, get kind of Zhong Jinna trapped inside that wall so she can get that takedown. But she's trying to strike with her. She's trying to put hands on Zhong Jinna, but that speed advantage is too much, Michael.
Final stages of the fourth round of five. We're almost 20 minutes into this match. Zhong Jinna has managed to keep it standing for most of the time. Michelle Nicolini is going to get some much needed instruction in a moment. They've got to find a way to solve the riddle of the champion, to pick the lock, to put the pieces of the jigsaw together and unravel Zhong Jinna.
But Michael, the biggest difference between this match and the Tio match is you could see visibly Michelle Nicolini was done. This is not the case here. She is still dangerous. She can still get this match to the ground and look for a finish. But she's got to be more aggressive. There has to be some urgency coming from Michelle Nicolini, because right now, Zhong Jinna is starting to let those hands go. See how she just reaches out there and stops the head like that with the takedown defense? Michelle has to set that up better.
Nicolini, can she latch onto a leg? Can she clinch up on the body of Zhong Jinna and get the champion down to the ground? Zhong Jinna now coming on strong again with the punches and landing Dragon.
Yeah, it's that second and third shot coming from Zhong Jinna. I'd like to see her put together more of those. Really start to put combinations together, because right now she's only throwing two pieces, right? The first shot is a distraction, but the second shot is landing. If there was a third or a fourth, she might be able to get Michelle Nicolini out of there. But right now she's up against the wall. Let's see what Michelle can do. Good movement coming from Jinna.
Let's go. Choke!
Yeah, she's tired. Let's go. Push up this.
Body head.
Let's go.
Oh, she might be hurt here, Dragon.
Choke!
I wonder if it's a shot to the chest that she took here.
Yeah, that's what she's complaining about, but it's kind of a legal shot. Like, you can't attack that area. Like, it's not illegal. Nice little overhand right there landed by Zhang Jina. You can see she's trying to reach. That's the opportunity. Boom, throw an uppercut.
At this stage, you've got to wonder what Michelle Nicolini has left. And now she's on the ground. This is where Michelle wants to be. Is this the time for Michelle Nicolini? She's still got plenty of time to try and finagle a finish, to try and submit the champion. This is Michelle's world dragon.
If anybody can do it right now, look how she traps the arm with the overhook on Zhang Jinan's right side. You can see that that arm is kind of trapped. If she can get her right foot out of the armpit of Zhang Jina, there's a triangle there, right? So it's very important that Zhang Jina keeps that foot underneath her armpit. Good. So you can see how she's trying to get it out. Oh, she gets it out, keeps a hold of it, but Zhang Jina rips the arm out to save herself from a possible submission. Man, my heart skips a beat every single time there's one of those altercations, because I know just how dangerous Michelle Nicolini is.
Mitch, with that attempt on the ground, coming this late into the fight and not being able to capitalize, will that mentally deflate Michelle Nicolini?
Oh, she hurt her there with the shot. Michelle went down for a moment. And Zhang Jina skips away as she's dancing out. Olivier Cost forces Michelle Nicolini back up to her feet. She's got 90 seconds. Right now, she's got to put the foot down as she tries to reach in for the takedown. Zhang Jina, again, showcasing good takedown defense. And Olivier Cost says, get back up. Let's dance for the last 80. Michelle lunging in
Michelle
with the punches.
Michelle Nicolini full of desperation now.
Trying to get that punches to close that distance. It looked like Zhang Jina could have let the hands expose, the fingers get her in the eye, but Michelle says she's okay to keep going. Last minute here. This is our vital 60 seconds right now for Zhang Jina. She probably has a pretty significant lead at this point in time, but right now Michelle Nicolini is still dangerous. She has flying attacks in her arsenal. She can do it, so it's very important that Zhang Jina keeps stinging her and moving, touching her, letting those hands go and circling away. Lots of high fives going on right now. Zhang Jina pushes forward, gets the tight. Good job again to avoid that clinch. The takedown defense has been the story of this game, and when things did get to the ground, Zhang Jina did all the right stuff. Michelle getting touched up here in the final seconds as Zhang Jina starts to let those hands go. Big overhand right, punctuates it with a leg kick.
Zhang Jina,
by unanimous decision, and still one women's strawweight world champion, Zhang Jina.